Hello and welcome to Akshu's Kitchen. Today we'll see how to prepare vegetable cannelloni, for which we will need the following ingredients to serve approximately 3 to 4 people. Some mixed vegetables of your choice. Today I'm using mushrooms, carrots and capsicum, that is bell peppers. You can use any additional vegetables of your choice like sprouts or radish or any vegetables, and you can also skip any of these vegetables if you don't like them. And 2 large onions finely chopped, 3 cloves of garlic finely shredded, 50 grams of butter, unsalted butter, and 40 grams of plain flour, 200 ml of milk, and some grated cheese. I'm using a mix of mozzarella and cheddar cheese, and some fresh lasagna sheets, 1 tin of chopped tomatoes, approximately 400 grams in weight, some mixed Italian herbs and fresh basil. I don't have the fresh basil today, so I'm using the frozen one. You can use either of them. Some grated parmesan cheese. First, in a small pan, I'm going to melt the butter, and when it melts, I'm going to add the 40 grams of plain flour and mix it thoroughly so that the flour is completely absorbed by the butter. And once it's all mixed completely, I'm going to add the 200 ml of milk little by little so that it does not form lump and it retains a smooth consistency. So add little by little, and once all the milk is added, keep on stirring it continuously in a medium flame. Also add salt and pepper to taste, about a pinch of pepper and 1/4 teaspoon of salt, and keep on stirring it continuously so that it does not get burnt at the bottom or form lumps. Now you can see it has got a thick consistency. So when you obtain this consistency, switch it off and keep it aside. Next, in another pan, I'm going to add some olive oil, about 2 tablespoons of extra virgin olive oil, and when it is hot, I'm going to add the 3 cloves of garlic which I finely shredded. Totally I have 6 cloves of garlic grated, so I'm using only half of it. I'm saving the remaining 3 cloves of garlic for later use. And once this garlic turns golden brown, I'm going to add half of the chopped onion. I've got 2 medium sized onion chopped, so I'm adding only 1 medium chopped onion now. And when it turns light golden in color, I'm going to add the 1 tin of chopped tomatoes, that's approximately 400 grams in weight. If you don't have the chopped tomatoes, just blanch and grind 4 to 5 medium sized tomatoes, and you can add the tomato puree, that will also work good. So I'm going to close this with a lid and cook for about 10 to 15 minutes in low to medium flame until all the tomatoes get cooked and they become soft and pulpy and all the moisture is reduced. So it will take definitely around about 15 minutes. Now after 15 minutes, you can see all the moisture is absorbed and the oil has started to ooze out. So in this stage, I'm going to add the herbs, that's the mixed Italian herbs. I'm going to add about 1/2 teaspoon of it, and once this all completely mixed, I'm going to add the 1/4 teaspoon of black pepper powder, and this is the time to add the fresh basil leaves as well. Today, as I said, I'm using the frozen basil. I'm going to use about 1 tablespoon of basil. If you don't like the flavor of basil, you can skip it or reduce the amount, and also add salt to taste, around about 1/2 teaspoon of salt. Mix them all together, and now to obtain a sauce consistency, I'm going to add around about 1/4 cup of water. So it's all dry now. When you add a little bit of water, it attains the sauce smooth consistency, and now the tomato sauce is ready. We have already prepared the white sauce or bechamel sauce. Now the red sauce or the tomato sauce is also ready. Next, we'll prepare the vegetable stuffing. For that, in another pan, I'm going to add about 2 tablespoons of oil, and when it is hot, I'm going to add the remaining 3 cloves of garlic and fry it well until it becomes light golden color, and then add the remaining 1 medium sized onion and fry it well until it gets light golden color. And once it turns a little bit in color, I'm going to add the vegetables which we have already kept ready in small pieces. I have coarsely grated the carrot, cut the mushroom into small pieces, and the bell peppers or the capsicum into small pieces. As I already said, you can use any vegetables of your choice, add any vegetables or skip any of these vegetables, and fry it all well for about 5 to 6 minutes until they become soft and get reduced in size. Again, at this stage, I'm going to add about 1/2 teaspoon of mixed Italian herbs, 1/3 teaspoon of black pepper powder, 1/2 teaspoon of salt to taste, and mix them all together. So now the vegetables are also ready. Now it's time to add the prepared white sauce or the bechamel sauce to the prepared vegetable stuffing. Combine the white sauce and the vegetable well together, And now you can see this is the perfect consistency. The vegetables are all well merged in the bechamel sauce. Now it's time to arrange the pasta sheets. So I've got fresh pasta sheets. I'm going to line it in a tray and fill it with hot boiling water and let it soak in the hot water for about 5 minutes or according to the instructions on the package. And after 5 minutes, you can see it has expanded in size. I have drained the water out, and with the help of a kitchen towel, I'm going to wipe all the sheets one by one so that there is no moisture in the sheet and keep one of them ready. I'm going to cut this sheet into 6 or 8 according to the size of the sheets you are using. Make sure it's around about 2 inch in length and 1.5 inch in breadth. I'm going to fill the prepared vegetable stuffing in each of the small sheets in one edge, and starting from one edge, I'm going to give one roll until it reaches the other end. Do not use large sheets, then there will be more of pasta sheets than the filling. So make sure you are able to roll only one roll and it reaches the other edge. So I'm going to do this until all the sheets are used and all the fillings are used, and then I'm going to grease the baking tray with some oil and line the prepared cannelloni tube one by one, starting from one end of the baking tray and making sure that you line them evenly and tightly without any gap in them. And now it's all lined up. I'm going to pour the prepared tomato sauce on top of the arranged cannelloni and spread it evenly. And again, on top of this, I'm going to add the 200 grams of grated mozzarella cheese and cheddar cheese. If you want only the mozzarella cheese, then you can add just the mozzarella, but the mix of mozzarella and cheddar gives a good flavor to your cannelloni. Also, sprinkle some grated parmesan cheese over it, and it is ready to go to the oven. Bake at 200 degrees Celsius for about 15 to 20 minutes or until the top layer, the cheese layer, becomes golden brown in color, and vegetable cannelloni is ready. Allow to stand for about 2 minutes and then you can serve. Just scoop 3 or 4 cannellonis in a batch and transfer it into a plate, and you can serve it with any salad of your choice. This is a very delicious Italian recipe. Try it and you will really like it. Thank you for watching Akshu's Kitchen.